3, 2, 1, live. Hi, Aubrie and Sarah.
Hi, Dave.
So today we have the Power Sisters. I'm going to call you the Power Sisters. Aubrie Jones and Sara Rawlins. And super proud of you guys. You've done like some really awesome stuff and started your own company.
Thank you. Yes, thank you.
Hadco is the name of the company, mm-hmm. and what Hadco does is staffing solutions. Mm-hmm. So how did this all start? You go first, Aubrie?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, Sara and I have a long history in the corporate event planning world, and we worked for a very large corporate event planning company here in Vegas for, Sara was there for... Well, in the industry for both about 30 years combined.
Yeah.
I was on the sales side, she was on the ops side.
But not just hosts or not?
And
just...
another one before that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's right. Okay, yeah. I remember.
And so we would do everything from transportation, entertainment, you know, venue procurement, all this stuff. And we just were getting really tired and, you know, we wanted to make a name for ourselves and... not work for anybody anymore.
Yeah,
quite honestly. But we also were kind of, you know, just had different priorities in life. And so we started looking at kind of what was out there and noticed that there's so many temporary staffing companies in Vegas, but there's none that have the hands-on experience that Sara and I do in the event world. And as you know, Vegas has so many large conventions and meetings and events and specialized things where we have been just so fortunate to... really capitalize on that market, and you know, in a year and a half, we're just killing it.
I love it.
Yeah.
So let's go back a little bit, okay? So, I mean, you and I used to sing in a band together.
Yeah, that's right.
You were the lead singer.
Yeah.
But I mean, so you went from being a singer in a band, mm-hmm. and then you went into real estate, right?
Yep.
And Sara, you were doing what at the time?
So I've always been in event planning since I've come to Las Vegas.
Oh, okay. So you've always been in event planning.
So I used to book your guys' band or actually operate it, not book it.
Yeah,
but,
right.
But yeah.
So you've been doing that for forever.
Yes.
And then after the real estate thing, I mean, that was like around 2007, 2008 that you stopped doing real estate, right?
Yep. So I was in a relationship, and we both were doing real estate, and it was just, you know, the market crashed, and it was really scary for both of us to be in it, and this opportunity arose for me to join the company that Sara was working for and on the sales side, and so that's when I did, and sales has always been my passion, and that was kind of history.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you guys were working for the, it would be a destination management company, which for those of you who don't know, is basically a company that will, you know, hire events, hire people, do all the food, the catering, and all of that kind of stuff like that
everything.
Is what a destination management company is. And mm-hmm. that's what the company that you guys were working for. Yeah. Sara, you were the like a lead person there, right?
Right. So I was the director of operations at both companies that we worked for. So
okay, and Aubrie was in sales.
Yes, and then by the time we left, Aubrie was the vice president of sales, and I was the director of operations. So we kind of ran the company together along, you know.
Right.
She ran the ops side, and then I ran the sales.
So when was it something that you guys had talked about for a long time, or was it something? I mean, doing something like this was it? How did the idea actually? I mean, you said that you didn't see a lot of companies in town with the same type of experience that you guys had running their staffing company. Yep. So how did it all, like, how did you guys decide to do it? Like, and what was the whole process of?
So in 2016, I decided 2017 was going to be my last year. And after Aubrie not thinking it really was going to be my last year, she came came on board with me to leave as well in April of 17. And then Aubrie did all the groundwork. I'll let you. I mean, she figured out this Hadco Staffing Solutions. Like,
And I think one of the reasons we, I didn't want to not work with my sister, and I really saw that it was a reality that this was going to happen. So I wanted to kind of look at what could we do together and still work together.
Play on our strength of event planning.
Right. So I actually talked to my cousin. We're from Nebraska. Go Big Red. Just so you see the little pictures. But he has a staffing company in Lincoln, Nebraska, where we're from.
And, oh, really? So, okay. Yep. So you had someone close that had
the same company. But very different. Yeah. Like, and my mom helped, our mom helped him build it in the first years.
Oh, okay.
But he bought a franchise. And they focus on manufacturing and like light industrial. So it was something that, you know, not that it's impossible for us, but that's not what we excel in. Like, you know, when people call us and ask for, you know, a specialized, I don't even know.
We like, have to Google it.
Don't say that out loud. No, now we just call our cousin. But anyway, he had very similar path, like with me, like he was in pharmaceutical sales and was very strong at sales. We just had a lot of similar paths. And the original thought was, is that we were going to take a year and then open an event planning company, our own.
That was
kind of the original idea. But then I started thinking about it. He's like, you know, you really should, you should own your own company. And so I started thinking about this and I was like, gosh, you know, because we would hire temp companies every now and then at our old job. And it was just not really strong results and not meeting the expectations of what we needed. And so we really thought there was a smart. So I approached Sara and I said, what about this? And she's giving me 3 years. And I'm down to a year and a half just to work really, really, really hard like we have been.
Yeah.
I know she'll stay longer. She's going to stay, but that's the whole goal, right?
Oh, so she only gave you 3 years of her life and then she's like,
working really hard.
Of working as hard as she has been.
Okay.
That's, so then, because we're, you know. But so then Aubrie decided not to go down the franchise route, and so she opened Hadco, and we've done it together.
We opened Hadco,
And what would be the, would there really be that much of an advantage to have a to have it be a franchise company, or?
Well, yeah, because, you know, like, they know how to run a business, and they, but I'll tell you, we have surrounded ourselves with really great support system and people who have knowledge, and I did a lot of research and found the right people to work with us to help, and, you know, whether it be our insurance or payroll and all that stuff. So it would not have been an advantage now. You know, I will say this, like, I understand buying franchises is so smart, but I also didn't want us to get stuck, because if we didn't like this industry, like, we would have been stuck. And so, and the whole idea was to open an event side, you know, after our year of, you know, was up.
Yeah.
And then we decided that we really could, like, have a great balance and life balance with our family. Like, we have more time
and
with our families.
And not have to worry about dealing with events and all of that kind of stuff like that.
Like, last night, we did a massive, we provided about 44 staff last night.
44?
Yeah.
Oh, God, we've done, like, 300.
On one job. But, like, we had other jobs going on as well. So we probably had 75 people yesterday out working.
Which is still, but I mean, like, last week at one of the major casinos, we had 150 food and beverage staff working. So, I mean, it's, we do that very, you know, for only being in business for a little over a year. Like, but it was like, it was for an event company that we provided the staffing for.
A DMC.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, former competitor. But it was like, it was nice because we checked our staff in and then we got to leave.
Yeah.
And we didn't have to stay and worry.
There's always so much pressure with, you know, when you are the event company and you have to deal with the clients and, you know, this way you guys just kind of get your employees there, make sure they're doing what they're supposed to be doing, right?
But as a little plug, that's why so many companies are using us, because they know we get it. We know their pain. Like, we know the challenges, things they'll face, and we want to be a really good partner and support system to them. Like, we're not going to just check out if things are starting to fall apart. Like, we're there to help, and even if we have to put on our old hats, and if we need to help, like, we're all about supporting our clients and
Yeah. And do you ever find that it's hard to find like the right employees? Do you have people that you kind of go back to all the time? Do you have, I mean, how is that whole, that's got to be a little bit of a headache. Yeah. I mean, right. To some extent.
Yeah. We definitely have learned so much in the past year and a half since we've been open. Reliability is probably the most, you know, like our top factor. And
I'm sure.
We've gotten it down to a pretty much a science, like, you know, yeah. like who we know will be there. But yes, we do have our regulars that we like to keep busy because we want them. What our whole tagline is making lives better together. And so we definitely want to make people's lives better. So if they get full-time jobs, that's wonderful. But we love like those people that have a part-time job and then use Hadco as their part-time job too. So we try to keep those right. people busy so that they can make a living. And so we have our regulars that we do, but they don't let us down. They arrive. They're great. They represent our brand.
And every now and then you probably have to have somebody that's new and you're sure of. I mean,
yeah.
How would you... I mean, to find 75 temporary employees with, I mean, yeah. not, I mean, Vegas doesn't have a really high unemployment rate. I mean, it's got to be like really hard to find.
They don't have a high unemployment rate, but what Vegas does have, which is so awesome and different from, I think, a lot of markets, is that there are so many people in this city that our city's 24 hours. So yeah. there's a lot of people that work during the day, but then want to pick some jobs up at night.
Right.
Or vice versa. You know, we have labor jobs where it starts at 10 o'clock at night and goes till 4 in the morning. So it's like there's people that pick. That's one advantage of Vegas. But also there are so many people that freelance and kind of do, hey, yeah. I'm going to work this job and work this job. And so it's really like amazing and kind of an anomaly like in this market, because my cousin, you know, he says he has more jobs than people that he can fill right now.
Oh, really?
Because wow. of the and yeah. that's what I think a lot of staffing companies are challenged with right now, and because the unemployment is so low across the United States. But yeah. for us, well, like for example, we have so many staff and great qualified staff that we use frequently enough. But like when we got we were told on Friday for 150 staff for the following Thursday. And we did it. And it's, so we had a bulk of those, but then we recruited. And so we opened our office.
How do you recruit? How do you get people? I don't even understand how you would like. Yeah.
Go ahead.
No, we're very fortunate that we have word of mouth referrals a lot. So a lot of our employees, they refer their friends and family. We also advertise, and one of the things that I think sets Aubrie and I apart, and not to say other staffing companies don't do this, but we personally meet with each employee, every person. Either Aubrie meets them or I meet them.
Really?
And so of those 150 staff, I knew 130 of their names, and the other 20 was just because Aubrie and I were busy and I didn't get to meet them. And we pride ourselves on that, like being able to say, we have qualified staff because we chat, you know, we talk with them.
We know their backgrounds. We know what their skill sets are.
Do you remember their names?
Yes.
You do?
Yes.
Oh my God. I would fail miserably at this.
You look at people should look at our Google reviews. Like people, they are so amazing. Like people are like, this is the best company I've ever worked for. And
they like to call us the sisters.
Yeah.
Oh,
and
that's
I think
great.
They like that we're very hands-on and involved because we're building our brand and we're building our company. And it's, but we also are very respectful and kind. And this is to somebody making $9 an hour or a lot more, you know?
So let me ask you this. Now, you have obviously employees that make $9 an hour or that are like, you know, banquet people and you know, they get paid what they get paid, whatever. What about, do you ever have to hire like advanced skilled people? Like, would you ever have to hire like an audio technician or something, you know, just as an example?
Sure. Yeah. So two things on that. There are positions for sure that, you know, we do a lot of admin, you know, that have to have certain skill sets. We do have specialized, like we have one right now for a purchasing coordinator, we have sales. But so those are sometimes like temporary to permanent placements. But another big arena that we've really capitalized on is I do a lot of executive search and direct hire. And so what that means is I have a lot of DMCs across the United States come to me and say, I need to find a senior business development person. And it's for the market in San Francisco, but it's in our industry, the meetings and events industry. And so then I do search, I start interviewing people on the phone or in person, just depending on where the market is. But
that's and you like find a them fee. An employee, basically.
Yep. And then they start and there's, you know, a flat fee for that. So that's been a whole nother side because, again, there's not a headhunter or a recruiter that I feel is super versed and strong and understands the meetings and events industry like we do. Mm-hmm. And yeah. So.
And word's getting out.
It is. Like we're
no, on that's fire awesome. Right now.
We're placing all over the
United
States.
Are you really?
Yeah. Yeah. Wow. But we've that's done amazing. Probably about 16 to 18 full-time placements. And some of them are like high-level placements. So it's been great.
So does the commission that you make on it, is it dependent on their salary?
Yep.
Is it kind of a direct percentage yep. of that kind of thing?
Exactly.
Wow, that's yep. great. And also, is it a one-time thing? Is it a one-time thing? It's just a one-time commission?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
But I mean, like I have
but
one
you
company.
Have a repeat client.
Yeah, but I have a company who's used me for like six of their hires.
Wow.
You know what
really?
I mean? So it's kind of been, yeah. I think again, we just placed somebody here in Vegas, and they're part of a large group of DMCs, and so they just blasted it out onto their board and just said how great of an experience they'd been looking for a couple of months, and I found somebody in a week and a half for them. And
wow.
It's like
really?
Done. Yeah. She's hired.
Like
Aubrie's
what,
a really, really good recruiter. Like especially in our industry. You
like
know,
what kind of specialized things though?
Are, like positions are, that Sarah and I used to hold.
Like that kind of
yeah,
really high level
so like,
stuff. Huh?
Uh-huh.
Wow.
I mean, some have been director level, but like most of them are, you know, a senior events manager, which is like an operation, a senior level of to run, you know, programs
wow.
and events. And some are finding good salespeople that like get our industry. It's hard, but
like running registration sites for,
yeah.
you know,
mm-hmm.
those,
wow.
those have been
yeah.
Lot.
So,
that's,
yeah,
that's really cool.
Yeah.
So now I got to ask you this because I would think that this would be something that you guys would run into. Do you get people who call you and say, can you find me a computer programmer or something really random that you guys aren't really,
mm-hmm.
don't really do? Does that happen
yeah.
occasionally?
Just last week or this week.
Yeah. And it's a direct hire situation. And I think we have enough resources to assist. But there's been times where people have called us for specific positions or employees will call and say, hey, do you look for, and we're really honest with them. Listen, this is what we excel in and what our expertise is in.
Yeah.
So, you know, I think that you might be able to find a better fit. But sometimes if it's customer service related or things that like we know that we would be able to find, we'll proceed with it. But we'll usually, you know, if we don't feel, well, we've never not had that happen. I don't want to like say that it never will happen, but we're not afraid to say like, this is not our expertise.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
that's what I
just
think a good company does, you know,
yeah.
but they usually still go with us because, you know, Aubrie's a closer.
I pay her a lot of money. Just kidding.
You are a closer, aren't you?
I am.
when we used to sing in the band, like if the crowd wasn't reacting, Aubrie would like yell at them.
Well, I was like, come on.
Yeah, I know, right?
Well, you know,
she does that sometimes to our temper in a nice way.
Come on.
Smile, you guys.
So wait a minute. So let me ask you this too. So when they're working for you, when these, you know, people that you hire are mm-hmm. working for you, do they have a dress code? Do they have is that something that you guys deal with or
yeah.
how does that like
Yep. I so mean, basically when we so we have, you know, kind of like three different parts that we do. We have just the temporary jobs, we have the temp to permanent jobs, and then we have the direct hires. So those
okay.
are the
yeah.
three avenues. So the majority of our, not the majority, but a lot of our jobs are just like temporary jobs
right.
where I need 10 people to do this or that. So we have this event detail confirmation, and it just spells everything out for them. But we our dress code is always just all black, black button down. It's just very standard. It's a lot of our clients like to provide t-shirts for our staff or their own uniform.
The large conventions, usually it's like their brand. Yeah. But we're really specific. It's not just all black. It's black, long sleeve, button down, collared shirt. And we put pictures. A picture.
We learned, you know. And we're like small earrings, hair back, like nice makeup, nice nail, you know, like so there's usually not confusion, but
well
sometimes we'll get black jeans and it's like no black slacks. So
Or you know the short pants are like in right now, like the you know how, and I'm like, this is not a fashion show. Like, we are here to be a server, and you need to have on black slacks, you know, or, you know. But we've learned our, I mean, we've definitely, while we feel like, that we're really strong, and we are, but there's definitely been some learning curves for us, you know, like, and you have to spell it out sometimes.
Yeah, I'm sure.
And people don't read, and like, and we know that from our past,
and we went from knowing everything about everything at our old job to knowing, like, learning something new every day, which is rewarding, you know?
Yeah, that's great. And I mean, it's gotta be when you, so when you hire like somebody, do you actually, speak to them about the, what the job is going to be about? Do you tell them, or do you just hand them like, or do you send them an email and they're supposed to read the email?
We usually then
they don't read the email. Right. I mean, or do you actually take the time to spell things out for them? I mean,
in the interview process, we usually kind of explain the types of jobs that we have. Because while a lot of them are different, we focus on kind of three main arenas, which is like the conventions, you know, which is that, and then food and beverage, and then probably like special event type staff. So the conventions is like once people start doing it, it's kind of like, they know, oh, you're going to be registration staff, or you're going to be directional, which is holding a sign. And but we're on site a lot, especially for our large programs and larger special events, so that we can help guide, because we want to really train our people. And that's what I feel like. They feel like we're investing in them, because I think a lot of, from what we've heard, a lot of, and this is no disrespect, but I've heard from our team that a lot of other temp companies, they just feel like a number, which I understand that too. When they start getting so big, you're just like, but we try to really remember that this person has a 6-year-old daughter, or that his birthday is next week. And we try, you know, and I think we do a really good job. And I think that's why people want to work for us. They're really loyal to us, you know?
Mm-hmm. That's great. Yeah. That's great. So how many people do you, do you have employees working just for you at this point, or do you try to do most of it yourself, or?
Oh,
internally.
We've got two other people.
You have two other people.
Yeah.
And then, and so they just, and do you guys have an office? Do you have, okay.
We're literally right down the road from you, but like off of Pebble. We're in Henderson.
Oh, okay.
So yeah, we're right off the 215. And,
love it.
But yeah, we have Eileen, who is our office administrator. So she kind of handles the front door, phones, but she also helps with payroll. She does so much. She doesn't
and she puts up with us.
And she, because that's half the battle, is finding the right person to deal with
but
us.
But isn't there, there must be a ton of paperwork to deal with for you guys. I mean, do you do most of that yourself, or do you have somebody that deals with most of the paperwork?
And so that's
got to be a like
just new hire paperwork alone, the I-9s and the W-4s, and because we
that's what I mean.
Yeah, so she handles all of that for us.
Oh, okay, okay.
We kind of do a flex schedule with her, so she's there on Saturdays. So Aubrie and I aren't there to ask her to do other things, so she can just focus on the paperwork on those. But just, you know, we have over 1,000 people in our database.
I'm sure. So, yeah. You know, it's got to be a lot.
Just
to,
over the year and a half, don't you think?
Deal with.
Yeah. It is a lot. And it's, but we also have another friend of mine who actually went to college with me, and we used to perform together actually, but she is helping part-time too. And then we bring people in like for special projects too, like to help, like when we have large shows, to help with, you know, creating staffing. Our event details or calling people or.
So what is the most, what would be like the most, what is the most time consuming day-to-day task for you guys doing this type of thing? This is all new to me. So
interviews.
Yeah.
Oh, interviews.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Because we do take that time and meet with each person. We do, We kind of just do open interviews on Tuesdays and Wednesdays from 10 to 3. Mm-hmm. So that's on our website as well. So we just kind of focus that day. But basically from 10 to 3 on those 2 days a week, we just do interviews.
And sometimes it's quieter than others. You know, I mean, when we're specifically looking for something, it'll be busier. But when we first opened, we let anybody come in at any time because, you know, but then we were like, okay, we're starting to get busy. Like, we have to monitor this. And so it's worked out pretty well. But then when we have like a certain position we need to fill, we'll invite them in like the next day, you know, that kind of thing. So, but it does take time just because it's like, meanwhile, your emails are starting to fill up. And so you're just, you know, it's.
Yeah.
But it's also one of the most fun parts of our job because we get to meet like really cool people.
Sure.
And some not so cool, but that's okay.
We've learned a lot.
We have learned a lot.
Have I said that before?
So what do you do with the, and I know, because I know neither one of you speak Spanish. What do you do about the language barrier?
Eileen speaks Spanish.
Our front office administrator.
Okay. Yeah. I had figured you must have had that covered because that's got to be something.
Well, but I mean, we haven't needed it a ton.
Yeah.
But we do have a particular client who a lot of her internal people, you know, speak Spanish. And so she's just like, we like it if they're bilingual. So it really has come in handy for that particular mm-hmm. client. But that's more on the labor side of things.
The other day, Aubrie.
And Estudio Español en Escuela por 4 años, ¿sí?
But
wow, that's good. I'm impressed. It's probably the only thing you know in Spanish.
Sí.
She did. I heard her on the phone the other day and she went, Eileen aquí mañana. Which means Eileen's here tomorrow.
Really broken up badly. But it was like, I know enough to where I can at least say this. But we have, I mean, honestly, besides this particular client, we haven't really had an issue with that.
Vegas, a lot of people are bilingual. It's mm-hmm. not just Spanish.
So. Yeah. Wow. That's awesome.
Yeah.
It's got to be crazy. Like, you know.
You should come in on an interview day.
I should. It would be really fun.
You'd have a lot of fun.
So how did you get your client base? You guys are both salespeople, I know, and I know you know a lot of people, but how did you kind of get it all started? I mean, how did you get your client base going?
We, you know, being in the industry that we were in before, we gave a lot of business to people, you know, like we booked a lot of venues, we booked decor, we booked, you know, and we just reached out to our internal circle of people who we supported through the years, and we have just been so blessed and fortunate that they all just kind of came back and started using us. And then
we reached out to our old competitors, like other DMCs, to say like, hey, if you ever need staffing, we're here. And that kind of has blown up.
And then just the convention and meetings, it's just really been word of mouth. A lot of the hoteliers have introduced us to their clients because they know again, mm-hmm. that like with us, they're getting, you know, not just a temp company. It's like people who really get it and understand. And we had the biggest compliment. We just did a big conference down at MGM a couple weeks ago, and somebody said, it feels like you handpicked every single person to be in this, in each position. And Sara and I looked at each other, we did. Like, we really about, like, because we know everyone has different strengths, but we know what those are because we know our people. And we know that, like, you know what? This person's going to be great with interacting with guests. This person's more of, you know,
a batch scanner.
Yeah.
Like smile and batch scan.
Sure.
So that was like the biggest compliment to receive because that's what our goal is. You know, we want to capitalize on people's strengths and, you know.
And since then we've gotten, this show was so impressed with us, so they referred us to all their other event planning friends, which have now used us. And it's just, we've been very fortunate.
Are you at the point now where you're like thinking about, oh my goodness, do we need to expand? Do we need to hire more people?
We definitely, like, and I'm not trying to brag, but I feel like Sara and I, we've always kind of said we do the work of like 5 people each. Like we just are very good, like multitaskers, but, we feel that like, because of the way our business is that right now we still can just bring people in on a contract basis, like when we're slammed. But yes, the plan is, I mean, I have a plan, like where we're going to go and like kind of what the next thing is. And as far as expanding, we are starting to, the plan's always kind of been possibility, like, yes, to, in some of those tier one markets where, you know, where they have, a lot of our clients maybe go to those cities, you know, but we want to be careful too, because I've seen that happen, and we don't want to grow too quick to where we start to, so we're really feeling like our foundation is solid here, but we still need to tweak some things, and, you know, I think after that 2-year mark, we're really going to look at going beyond. And I have to also say this. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to. But we have to talk about how we just got certified, too. So I don't want you to forget about that, because it's really important.
You got certified. Okay. So we certified are, means what we, in the staffing
we,
solutions?
Well, no. It's not staffing solutions. It's just like business owner company. It's we are WBENC certified, which is Women's Business Enterprise. And it's like a huge... huge deal, and it took me over a year like to do it all, and we finally got it, but what it does now is it opens another door of possible clientele to us. Not just that, it's obviously a community of women-owned companies supporting one another and, you know, building each other up and learning. Like, there's seminars and educational things that we can take advantage of, but it also with WBE, a lot of Fortune 100 and 500 companies, you know, need, they have to like work with a certain percentage of minority owned companies, which women falls under that.
Wow. Yeah,
and so now when they reach out, they say, hey, we have this coming to Vegas. We need an event staffing company. And then we, you know, they reach out to us. So it's not just, obviously they want to find a qualified person, as you know, a qualified company, but it's something like we're super proud of. And like, there's a lot of women owned companies that they just won't do it because there's just so much work to get it done. And I was like, we are getting certified.
It's a huge vetting process too. Like yeah. I mean, Aubrie had to work on this for a year, like she said. So when they refer us, it's because we're qualified, because
we've,
you know, fit all these guidelines.
Yeah.
So that's a big feather in the cap, huh?
It's like just a huge like
compliment.
And it speaks to a lot of, you know, in the meetings and events industry, there's a lot of women that work in this industry. And so when they see that and they see that we're certified, like, it almost gives them even more, it almost is like, I want to support you even more, which is great. And it wasn't, but it's, you know, and just with the whole, you know, the year that we've had this year, you know, with just women and inspiring women, like, I have to say, like, our biggest motto with our company is when people come in, we get women that come in, like, I just love that you're a woman-owned company. And I'm like, I love it too. And I said, and we are so about building women up, but we're also about building men up. And like, that is our message. Like, our whole message is we want to build you guys up, because we get people that have struggled, and we get people that are down on their luck. We have people who can't hold a job for whatever reason, because they can't afford daycare, they can't do this, or they can't whatever. We have the full gamut, you know, and we have people who are retired and just want to have the social part of it, like everything. But I have to tell you, like, it's been so rewarding and hard. But like, when a gentleman that has worked for us in a warehouse, and it's for a company that provides furniture for conventions, and so it still ties into our industry. But when he came to us and said, hey, they're going to be calling you to verify my employment because I'm buying my first car ever. Like, we had a part of that. Like,
that's
the moment
awesome.
That, like, you're like, okay, this is all worth it, you know?
And yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
So, okay. So I have another little avenue of question to talk to you guys about. Okay. How are, like, the companies, like, because most of a lot of, I know it's a super, everything about the event industry is so competitive and so cutthroat. And I feel like some of the hotels, you know, not naming any names, but like MGM or Caesars or some of those.
Yeah. Who we love.
No, and I'm sure you guys work with them all the time. Yeah. But do they, I mean, because they want everything for themselves. So is there anything that like irritates you about how they do business, or has it been a positive experience with these big corporation type? I mean,
I think that it's a valid question, but I think that there's things that hotels will touch, and then there's things that they don't want anything to do with because it's not worth the return for them. Like, you know, I always feared when we were in the DMC industry, you know, there are certain hotel chains here that have like arms for decor and entertainment, you know, and
oh, absolutely. Right. I mean, so, which is why I asked the question. Yeah.
And so you always had to be careful about that, but it's like for staffing, none of them do it because there's not for $1 billion companies. They're not, the return on it is, it doesn't make sense to them and it's extremely time consuming. Yeah. So, you know, we've actually been blessed because a lot of the people that we worked with through the years, you know, the people in, you know, the CSMs or catering managers, like they introduce us. So we are very fortunate to have really great relationships with a lot of the hotels across the strip. And so it's a positive experience for us, but it's a total valid question. And it is competitive. And that was another reason the DM, it was so, everyone I knew was opening a new DMC and it was just like,
I know. I mean, that's like crazy. I mean, everybody wants their own DMC. It's like, mm-hmm. it's like whatever everybody wants. And then, I mean, I've noticed just from the events that I've done, you know, talking to like people from MGM and like, I know all these people and I've mm-hmm. known them for years and they're just going, you know, balls to the wall with trying to do everything themselves and just cutting out the DMCs, the local DMCs, you know, like hosts and, you know, destinations by design and all of those, you know.
Yeah, but. It definitely is. There's some things that changed in our whole industry, what is referred to as a third party. So a third party usually will hire a DMC to handle the local components. There was some things that happened in the third party world with hotel commissions, and a large brand decided to reduce the commission amount. And so all of a sudden we started to feel the ramifications from it because when they used to source everything through a DMC, like now they were sourcing some things on their own. And so it was cutting out revenue on our end, you know, in our past world.
Sure.
So it's just, you're right. It is, it's a really competitive world, but if you're good, you'll make it, you know? That's
It sounds like you guys have found a really cool niche. I mean, and this is the town to do it in, that's for sure, you know?
It is. I read something like, what makes a staffing company successful? And the two things they said was, one, be in a market that uses temporary staffing, and two, find your niche. And we truly have,
that's awesome.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad you guys came by.
Thank you for having us.
And Hadco Staffing Solutions, you look out for that company.
Thanks, Dave. We love you.
Yeah, and I guess we're signing off now. So say goodbye, girls.
Bye. Goodbye. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. We're thankful for you. Thank you.
Oh, well. I'm thankful for you to come over. I was looking forward to talking to you guys. So.
Us too.
All right, Executive Blonde, signing off.